All right, you guys, so today's gonna be a little different from all the other videos. I'm gonna hop into the, with my staff and my trainers here at the facility, and I'm gonna do some board and train work. So I'm gonna be talking out loud, working with some board and trains. You guys are gonna see behind the scenes of the staff and the new facility. And so if you like this type of video, let me know in the comments below. So you're gonna follow me around and basically go behind the scenes. Hey, don't write yourself off yet. It's only in your head you feel left out. But seriously, I haven't trained here in forever. That's why I'm excited to get going. Alright, I wanna show you guys Owen Patrick. He's one of the staff dogs. And he's so cute. He won't tell his mom that we let him out. Oh, baby boy. So all the staff dogs are in the staff training room. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of them. And I don't usually bring my dogs to work anymore because I work from home a lot, but they're all pretty cool. So we still have some construction going on, but this is our new area. This is where all the magic happens. So everybody's training, we got construction going on, we got our board and trains training, we got private sessions going on, we got interviews going on up front, a lot going on all the time. And this is our second location, so this is our bigger location, but a lot going on, it's exciting. So this is Zelda, one of our dogs that we're obviously working here on our board and train. So what I like to do is when I get a dog out, I do a little bit of obedience. I just did a sit, stay, and then a break. So Zelda's been here for a little bit, so we're already working on healing and threshold. So what I'm gonna try to work on is building threshold. So just making sure that when we ask Zelda to do obedience, we're gonna start integrating in some distractions, some realistic distractions. We're obviously working outside too, which is a distraction as well. Heel, good. Heel, good. So I'm just working on engagement there, making sure that we're engaged, doing some directional changes. Zelda, heel, come on. Good heel, yes, good heel. Yes, good, yes. Working on that engagement, good heel. So this is a little test that I like to do with most dogs when they're starting to advance their obedience. Take a piece of treat, stay. Yes, good stay. Break, good. Heel. So a little bit of, yeah, good. A little bit of pressure there, heel. Yes, good. This is Zelda's first session today, so I have to be mindful of that. Once a dog is tuned up for the day, the third or fourth session, we like to do 5 or 6 here per day, per dog. First session is always a little bit rocky, especially with the young, energetic dog. So we're just gonna work on that sit, stay again. So this is just thresholds. It's basic obedience, but what it does is it gives me an opportunity to really advance the basic obedience to advance. Zelda, sit. Good, sit. Stay. Nope, a little bit of pressure. Stay. Good stay. One more. Good stay, Z. Zelda. Engagement, good. So I'm working on that engagement to get paid for me. So the distraction's here. She looks up at me, she's gonna get paid. Zelda. Yes, good. So sometimes you can mark this with a focus or whatever. I'll have to talk to the staff to see if it's something they wanna do with her. Yes, good. So now I'm gonna put it into reality here as I'm gonna throw that piece out. Ah, sit. Good, stay. Zelda, Zelda. Yes, good. So just a little pressure on the leash. Zelda. Yes, good. Break, good. So now we're just gonna work on long distance healing here. So sniffing I don't care about, that I care about. We need this loose leash here. Ah. Yes, good check in. Payment for that. Good heel. Inside turn. Inside turn. Good heel. Watch the leash. This is what I'm focusing on. Heel. Yes, good. Heel. Good. Pay all that. That's good engagement. Good check in. This is what we're looking for, guys. Loose leash walking outside for long distances. She's checking in with me, so I'm going to pay her for that. Yes, good girl. It's important that when you guys are training engagement with food, that you have it locked and loaded. Don't wait, yes. Right when she looks at me, yes. Good heel, well done. auto sit. Lovely. Okay, break. What I'm using right here for treats is I'm using Stewart's Pro Treat, which is 100% beef liver freeze dried. It breaks up really nicely. And what I like to do when I'm working with dogs, Zelda, come. Yes, good. They'll actually take this one piece of food and I could use it. Sit, yes. Down, yes. Break. Zelda, come. Good, and I can use it over and over and over again. Same piece. I try to be as efficient as possible. So even on my way back to the kennel, I'll work the dog in obedience. And I'll just give you guys a glimpse of what that looks like with this door here. Grab the door like this. Good sit. Walk in. And then you break the dog through. Break, break. And that's just on your I love the enthusiasm from this girl. That's just on your terms. So that's a good way to start developing a more leadership role with your dog. Out of the kennel, out of the crate, outside, out of the side door. And you can practice this over and over again. You don't have to do it once a day when your dog goes out. It's really just a threshold game to say, hey, you don't make decisions unless I give you the permission to do it, because you don't want dogs to make those decisions based off of what they think. I'm gonna go grab another dog and do some more. Hey you guys, we're doing a giveaway on the Tom Davis Dogger 280C on this video. All you have to do to enter to win is subscribe to my channel, turn on your notification, like this video, and leave a comment down below to enter to win. So this is Sky. We're gonna do a little bit of obedience, then we're gonna transfer to the remote collar. I'm gonna get my sound box out so you guys know exactly what I'm doing with the remote. Just gonna start tuning her up, working her with a little bit of food, a little bit of basic obedience. Sky, heel. Directional change, heel. Yes, good. I give her a little bit hang time there. So I'm not correcting her right when I turn, I'm giving her an opportunity to turn. Sky, heel. Yes, good heel. Slowing down, that's called proofing. Sky's been with us a little bit longer than Zelda, so I'm not paying her as much. If the dog is new, or if I don't know a dog that well, or they're not working that well, they're maybe whatever, I'll give them a lot more rewards. She has different expectations in the future, and just what you just saw, she's gonna work just by my voice. So we got a distraction. I'm gonna work on thresholds and distractions. I'm actually gonna have you guys follow me out to my truck so I can get my sound box, but this is gonna be where training meets reality, because there's stuff going on out front. Directional change, heel. Yes, good heel. So you guys see that pop? Good heel. I'm gonna go back, heel, good. Sky, sit. Yes, heavy distraction going on here. Probably in for board and train as well. Good heel. That was very good. Yes, good girl. Okay, break. Basically what I did is I took an opportunity to say, hey, there's some realistic stuff going on. The dogs are barking at her, and she did actually really, really good. Our gate is actually opening right now, which will be another distraction. Let's get into that. Heel. Good heel. Good. And what I'm gonna do is just gonna let her soak this in. So I'm not gonna ask anything of her. Yes, she engages with me. Of course, I'm gonna pay her for that. Didn't ask her to do anything. So in situations like this, yes, good girl. Well done, good. See how she's, yep, a little nervous, tail's wagging. As soon as she looks at me, she's gonna get paid. Yes, good girl, good baby. Break. She sees something like that and she's like, oh my God, what is that? You could tell she's not seen it before. She's a little nervous. I let her soak. I didn't ask, hey, sit or pay attention to me. I want her to have a good encounter and really take, yeah, good girl. Good. So let's work on this again. She looks at me. Yes, good. What's up, Brett? Good. Good. Yes, good job. Check it out. Check it out. You got it. You got it. You got it, girl. Yes, good girl. Yes. See, now, really quick, just to touch base, like, that was stressful for her. Like, a lot of people in the dog training industry and dog owners even get confused about, like, stress. Like, that was super, that look, she just shook all that off. You probably didn't see it, but you heard it. But again, stress equals progression. Pressure makes diamonds. So that's what that was. And she's like, oh my God, I'm so afraid of this gate. And I'm like, hey, I know you are. I'm not gonna force you over here, but I got a treat. And she's like, I don't know. And she finally came over, she took the treat, she looked at the gate. It's not so bad. On the other side of stress, getting a new car, going on the first date, buying a house, building this freaking facility for all the dogs that we're working with is stressful. But on the other side of that is progression. And of course, that's what we're looking for. That's the beauty of dog training, is things will pop up randomly. We had the dogs, we had the gate, we had the contractors. Now we're gonna go back to our original goal, going out to the truck using thresholds. Sit, good sit, Sky, stay. Gate's opening, yes, good stay. That's threshold one, that gate opening and her not going through. Now I'm gonna go through, stay. Nope, little correction there. Nope, correction there. Holding, I'm gonna reset that again. Stay. I'm resetting it because I want her to do it fully successfully. Yes, good stay. Okay, break. It's nice to have a dog sit so they're not rushing out. But the bigger picture is this is a threshold. So when she passes through thresholds, gates, doors, etc., that's what she feels like she needs to do. Just like we just did with Zelda over there. You open that gate, boom, she wants to go through. And so what I did is I said, hey, wait for me. She's looking at me. Okay, break. And I broke her through. Let's see, she's probably gonna wanna jump in my truck. Yep. All right, well, we're not in here for that, baby. We are in here. Oh, you know what? I think it's in my book bag. Well, this is good training. Yep, thank you very much. So now we're going back through. So this is another opportunity to work on other thresholds. So we gotta go back into my office to get the sound box for the dog tris so you guys can hear what we're doing with the e-collar. So again, another distraction with the door, and that's what we're working on. Heel. Threshold one, good stay. Okay, break. Good job, baby. If you guys don't know about the No Bad Dog Members Club, it's a $19.99 subscription-based service. You guys are getting the full-length videos that you see here on YouTube. This is gonna be a 15, 20-minute video. The full-length video is an hour. You're getting the seminars. You're getting the No Bad Dog Army community. We are helping each other out. We're empowering each other. We're not punching down. We're not making fun of. We're not judging. It's a really special thing, and I'm so happy and grateful to be a part of it. Click the link below to join the official No Bad Dog Members Club. This is my not finished office, but just really quick while you guys are here, I just wanna thank everybody for sending me all the cards and the thank you notes. And the other day we got an Omaha Steaks box. My name is Matt, I have a service dog from Oakland. 99% of how I trained him, I learned by watching your work. I've struggled a lot, but keep at it. I'm hoping to be a pro trainer like you one day, so on and so forth. So we get this stuff all the time. Thanks, Matt. Thanks for everybody else that sends me picture of Hawk, all this stuff. Thank you guys for doing it. It's pretty cool to see. Lo and behold, my book bag with my sound box in it. So what we're gonna do, because she's gonna go home with the remote collar, we're gonna break out the Tom Davis 280C. Of course, that's my go-to unit. I created it for you guys. So we're gonna work on a little lifestyle obedience here. Sit, good sit, stay. We're gonna pair these the dog tris sound box on. Good stay, baby, you're doing so good. And we're gonna pair the e-collar so you guys can hear exactly what I'm doing. Good stay, I know. Right now, she's getting a little antsy. It's way past her threshold, it's a lot going on. So I'm gonna break her before she breaks herself. Okay, break, break. Good job, baby. We're just gonna take the e-collar. You guys can hear it. Yeah. So we're gonna do some e-collar stuff. We're gonna go outside and do some recalls. It's gonna be a lot of fun. They've been doing e-collar stuff with her earlier this week, so she is conditioned on it. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna put the 15-foot long line on. We're gonna do some recalls, have some fun, aren't we, baby? So we're gonna let her go out and be a dog. We're still gonna use a round of three. So we're gonna say her name, tell her to come, and we're gonna hold the nick continuous. Now it's important you guys have your food loaded, locked and loaded, so when she gets to you, it's really fun for her to recall. Sky, come. Yes, good girl. Bang, break. Good. So I'm not asking her to sit because that's not my expectation. I just want her to come to me and I want her to feel the e-collar. Sky, come. Yes. Good. Break. Sky, heel. So I'm tapping when I say heel. Heel. Good. Heel. Good, just tap and turns, baby. That's all it is. Now remember, for anybody that doesn't know about the remote collar, this is not a correction. She just knows that it's me. Sit. Good, stay. Ah, there, e-collar pressure there. She got up. I'm from a distance. I didn't give her any pressure other than the remote collar pressure. Ah, pressure there again. That's e-collar pressure. Good sit. If your dog is jumping like that on the sit stay, that's because they're used to recalling. So you've taught them. At some point, they're gonna sprint towards you. You wanna discourage that completely. Sticking them right there in the mud to say, hey, don't move and you get paid. Don't move and you get paid. Stay. Come out this way. Ah, nope. Stay. Good stay. Good stay. So this is gonna be hard for her, a hurdle. She's gonna start to realize, man, if I just sit here, I'm gonna get paid. Good stay. I come out. Good, I'm not going too far. Good stay, baby. So I'm just reteaching her to plant right there and stay. Every single dog that we have in there has a chart. We write down their sessions and on the side, we write down what they need to work on. I'm gonna jot that down. We need to work on the sustainability of the stay from a distance. That's what a training session will look like for our board and trains. We get them out, we do really good work, have good expectations, write down what they did, and then somebody else will grab her in the next half an hour to an hour, or maybe it'll be me.